Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer, and Happy New Year! Today we're going to review Omega Blade VR, a game released on the Steam Store December 24th, 2020. It's available for the Oculus Rift. Yes, another Oculus Rift exclusive on the Steam Store. Omega Blade normally retails for $14.99, and I got a free Steam key through the Steam Creator Connect program to review this game. Now, the past several VR reviews I have done have all been negative, and I don't have a good history with Oculus Rift exclusives on the Steam Store. They're generally pretty bad. So, unfortunately, I do have to tell you that this is not a good game, and I don't recommend it. Omega Blade VR is basically like a challenge-based wave shooter. That's the best way I can describe it. You're basically doing different challenges, and really the main goal of this game is to climb up the leaderboards, and that's where the challenge really comes from this game. So there are different types of challenges in this game. One of the gameplays is just your basic wave shooter, where you have a bunch of drones flying in the air and your job is to shoot them down and avoid any damage. You can move in this game. You basically have rocket launchers in your hand. So once you press the button, you propel yourself forward. So you have to physically turn, but then whatever direction you're facing, you can propel yourself forward, and you'll need to do that to avoid projectiles in this game. You can also physically move within your play space, and for some of the game types, it's just better to physically move rather than to use the rocket propellers, but in other ones, you'll have to use the rocket launchers in order to gain enough distance. You can also jump really high in the air. I haven't figured out why that's a part of the gameplay. You can do it, but I haven't seen any benefit to doing that. I guess if you just want to avoid projectiles, you can just launch yourself right up, but I really haven't seen much benefit to that. There is another game mode where you're using your swords, and basically all you're doing is reflecting back the projectiles that come your way. You do have to physically move within your space to avoid some of the other dangers. There might be like lasers or whatnot that you need to avoid. And then there's also just different types of shooting. One of them is just a regular target practice where targets just materialize in the air and you have to shoot them really fast, or you have to shoot the target that corresponds with the matching color. There's also like a sniper rifle that you use that you have to snipe off targets off in the distance. You'll have to use a scope, find the target, then zoom in, zoom out as fast as possible to get all the targets within a certain amount of time. There's also one where you have shuriken, and basically you're just shooting the shuriken at the flying drones. It changes up the gameplay just because of the way the shuriken targeting works. So it takes a little bit to get used to, but it basically works the same as the normal wave shooter where you're using your guns. So there's different challenges and whatnot, but they also have a lot of things in common. There's 20 total challenges in this game, and there's 3 total maps that you'll be looking into. Really, the main loop here is just trying to improve your score to climb up the leaderboard to number 1, hopefully. So that's the main core of the gameplay here. Omega Blade VR is running on the Unity engine. On my RTX 3080, I was getting a steady 90 frames per second. I did not experience any serious issues or bugs playing on the Oculus Quest 2 using the Oculus Link cable. There are absolutely no settings in this game available, whether graphical or comfort options or locomotion options. Like I mentioned, you can boost forward. That's the only sort of locomotion available in this game. You have to physically turn in this game. There is no smooth or snap turning available. The challenges from the levels definitely get more difficult as you progress in general. So when you get to the 20th level, that's definitely more difficult than the first level. But I did find that some of them were just a little bit more difficult. Like there was a difficulty spike randomly with some levels. And I saw some levels where there was only like one person that finished that level. And you could tell that in the previous level and the next level after that, there were a lot more persons who completed those levels. So you could tell that the difficulty spike was maybe a little too hard on some of the challenges. Unfortunately, I just did not enjoy Omega Blade. I can't say I had fun with any of the challenges available. I did try all of them. I didn't play all the 20 challenges, but I played, I want to say, at least 14, 15 of them. And I played all different kinds. I tried every single different type of challenge. It just wasn't fun for me. I found the gameplay just to be a bit dated. in 2020, 2021 now. I expect better VR content. And something like Omega Blade, unfortunately, isn't even better than something like Space Pirate Trainer, which brought a lot of these elements together in one package, which is just a lot more fun, a lot more physically active, just more engaging in the type of challenge that's available with Omega Blade. Omega Blade is just a little too rough around the edges. The core gameplay is not polished enough. I honestly wanted to stop playing this game after about 30 minutes, but I struggled through. I wanted to get at least 2 hours in. I didn't quite manage that. I got a little over an hour and a half, but definitely less than 2 hours into this game. I just wasn't having fun. None of the challenges were interesting. The gameplay would need to be totally revamped in order for me to recommend this game. It's not the worst game I've ever played, it's just that I've played so many better games of this type. And like I said, something like Space Pirate Trainer is just way better than this, and I would recommend getting that game over Omega Blade, which I believe Space Pirate Trainer came out in 2016, so that kind of tells you the state of Omega Blade coming out in 2021. It's just not very good. If I have to rate it, I would give it a 4 out of 10. You might like it more than I did, but just me being a VR veteran, this game brings nothing new, and what it does bring just been done better in other games. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. If you like my review, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day. Goodbye.